Hi friends, this is Rakesh from Let's Make Learning Simple channel. Now we are going to see what is a stock and how stocks are getting traded and what is the base for creating a stock. So first we will consider an example to see how stocks are getting created. So you and your friend, started a startup company. For first 2 years, you both funded the company. So from this third year, you thought that the company would grow at the extreme peak, but you need some fund. Both of you and your friend don't have that much amount. So what you are trying to do is you are trying to approach the public for funding. So you are trying to release the IPO. IPO means initial public offering. So what the IPO does is, whenever a company announces IPO, the real intention of the company is moving from private funded company to public funded company. So this is a transformation occurs whenever IPO is announced. The company will move from private to public. So when a company announces IPO, there would be some initial investors would be very keen to invest in a company. So what they would try to do is they would approach some broker to invest in a company. So if suppose you need only 1 lakh rupee for initial funding, so what we are trying to do is you are splitting that 1 lakh into 100 subparts. For each part, for each stock, the value would be 1,000. So 100 into 1,000 would be 1 lakh. So the 1 lakh is getting split into 100 stocks. Of each stock value is 1,000 rupees, and you are announcing that 100 stocks are available. 100 stocks are available for IPO. The persons who are interested can apply for IPO. So if suppose there are 20 members who are interested for investing in a company using 20 stocks. So 20 into 20, so 400 stocks. So the available stocks are 100, but persons who are interested to invest in the 400 stocks. So here what happens is the company will do some lottery based selection. Here the 400 stocks would put in a lottery system. That lottery system would select the random 100 member stocks. So once the approach is over, the company would announce that these are the eligible persons who can initially invest in a company with the amount of stock that they can invest. So what that person do is they would give that respective amount of the company and they would buy the stocks. This would happen in a dematerialized way. We will talk more about that in the upcoming videos. Once this happens, the contact between the company and initial invest gets over. So this is the primary market. IPO, initial public offering, is the primary market where primary or initial investors invest in a company. And then what the initial investors do is they will try to rotate these stocks or they will try to sell their stocks in the secondary market. The secondary market is called the stock exchange or stock market. So suppose I am the one of the initial investors, what I'm trying to do is I have 10 stocks of the company, 10 into 1,000, 10,000. What I'm trying to do is I'm going to sell 5 stocks to someone. So what I'm trying to do is I'm asking the price of 1,200. And I'm putting that 1,200 into, I'm trying to sell 5 stocks of value 1,200. So there are 5 members who are interested to buy these 5 stocks. So they are trying to bid price for these stocks. So using of value 1,100, 1,115 and 1,119. So I am saying that the highest bid value for this stock is 1,190. So what I'm trying to do is okay to sell this stock of value 1,090. So I'm trying to sell 5 stocks of 1,190. So the amount that I gain is 190 into 5. This amount would be the profit for myself, and this profit is only for me. This profit won't go to the company because the contract is got over after that IPO. So I got profit of 190 into 5. Then what I would do is I would try to sell 5 more stocks at some other time. So this is the basic what that is going in stock market. So we'll try to learn more about this in the upcoming videos. So before ending this video, I would explain about two terminologies that are mainly used in the stock market: bid price and ask price. What is a bid price? in the example that I have already explained, I told that whenever I am trying to ask, when I am willing to buy up stock of some particular value, let's call bid price. So I am bidding for a stock using some value, and whenever I am trying to sell a stock using some value, that is called ask price. So at the end of this video, you will see the channel icon at the topmost corner and the related videos at the bottommost corner. So please click on that for subscribing channel and watching related videos. Thanks for watching.